Have you ever wondered what's going on with aging? For example, why do stressed out people tend to look so much older than their biological age? Or why is it that when someone you know has experienced a really stressful event in their life, their hair seems to suddenly go gray overnight? What is going on with this? Or can we do something about this? I'm Shirley Archer, and today I'm going to talk about telomeres, aging, and the mind-body connection, and why you can do something about aging. You may have heard about telomeres, but not really understand what they are. So in every cell, we have chromosomes that possess our DNA. And at the end of the chromosomes, there are fibers called telomeres. Scientists have described them like the little plastic caps on the ends of your shoelaces. So as your cells age over time, those caps at the end tend to break down and fray and wear away. So over time, your telomeres shorten. And what we've learned from research is that shortening of the telomeres actually is indicative of the life of the cell, because when the telomeres become very, very short, the cell is no longer able to reproduce. As it shortens, the DNA becomes slowly damaged, and the cells don't reproduce as accurately. Loosely speaking, we get results such as gray hair and aging skin. It doesn't have the vibrancy that you see in youth, and that's part of the aging process. Related to this, and for which two scientists were awarded the 2000 Nobel Prize, is the discovery of the enzyme telomerase and the role that it plays. Telomerase, when it is available to the telomeres, actually helps to rebuild the length. So over the life of the cell, there's a process of shortening, rebuilding, and over time, it eventually becomes nearly gone. Certain things that we do can actually produce more telomerase, and that can therefore extend the life of the telomeres. A lot of research is showing that this is really a key factor in aging. It is not the only factor, because illness from disease and the strength of the immune system and other inflammatory conditions also contribute to aging. So what can we do about it now that we understand what telomeres are and that there is something called telomerase? Well, interestingly, studies have shown that factors such as psychological distress have a relationship to the production of telomerase and the rapidity at which the telomeres deteriorate. In one study with women who cared for disabled children and were under a lot of stress, they were found to have much shorter telomeres when compared with women of an equivalent age who did not have an equivalent life stressor. And other studies support this finding that there's a relationship between psychological distress and the health of these telomeres. So that connection and the fact that how we perceive stress and how we react and respond to stress affects directly our health and longevity. Another fascinating study was done with respect to the Mediterranean diet, which, as you may know, is one that is rich in fruits and vegetables, primarily minimally processed foods, and plant-based, with some meats, but not predominantly meats, and also characterized by an abundance of healthy fats and olive oil and the enjoyment of wine with meals. And what they found is that people who had followed the Mediterranean diet compared to others not eating those foods had also longer telomeres. And this was a very large and significant study. Other studies have shown that physical activity and people who are more active over a lifetime tend to have longer telomeres as well when compared with people of the same age who have engaged in very little activity, have primarily a sedentary lifestyle. And interestingly, people who engaged in mindful and mind-body activities such as yoga, tai chi, qigong, they have found that they have more telomerase activity, which is the enzyme that helps to extend the life of the telomeres. So this area of research is continuing to grow, but we're taking away from it a lot of very interesting lessons. Now, some of these studies are what we call associational. So they don't necessarily demonstrate a cause and effect, but they do show that the people who are more active, that the people who are engaged in these mind-body activities, that people who are eating this healthy, nutrient-rich diet, and who are effectively managing stress in their life with a more positive and healthy outlook are enjoying actually healthier cells. And this is exciting because it means that you can incorporate these tips into your life. Definitely lifestyle factors that you can integrate into your life that will promote your youthfulness on a cellular level. And what's very interesting, a leading researcher named Dr. Dean Ornish has done studies of what we call an integrative lifestyle. So one that involved people who followed a minimally processed plant-based diet, who did moderate walking regularly, who participated in yoga and meditation regularly, and stress management activities, as well as weekly group meetings with social support, actually enjoyed longer telomeres and had positive results when it came to their cancer, because this study was done with men with prostate cancer. They actually had shown growth in the telomeres and in a positive direction and a reduction in the cancer. So this is actually very significant. I know that this is a lot of information, and I will include in the description below links to relevant studies. And if you're excited by this and want to read more, I encourage you to subscribe to this channel so that you can continue to learn as I talk more in depth on each of these topics. I look forward to providing you with more updates as we continue to learn about these important steps we can take to promote our healthy longevity, youthful beauty, and happy life. Thank you so much for taking the time to join me.